What's up, everybody? Shane here, and today we're talking about Superbon and how he was able to knock out the legendary Giorgio Petrosyan, who will be played by Bob this evening. We're going to look at the minute details on the form, the setup, and make sure you stick to the end because I'm going to share a mobility drill for your hips to make sure that you have the flexibility for those high kicks, just like Superbon. Let's take a look. Okay, I'd like to look at this sequence leading up to the knockout because there's a couple of clues and details that we can learn a lot from. So there's a break in action, and then Olivier Coste, the referee, says, choke, which is tie for fight, and the fighters engage right back into the action. Now, they're standing at what I call the magnet range, which is just outside of punching and kicking range, and every time one fighter moves, the other fighter adjusts and keeps that exact same distance. So what happens is Petrosyan is inching forward, Superbon is inching backwards. He takes two or three steps, and then you'll notice he bounces in place, which now allows Giorgio to think he's close enough to land a punch. So he steps in from southpaw with that double jab, left straight. And what you notice Superbon does is he just extends his lead arm for that long guard as he fades some of his energy back. Now I mention that long guard because again, it's a clue. He uses it again to ultimately get this knockout. From here, Superbon counters with his signature rear roundhouse kick to the body. Back.
Instructions in Thai from...
At this point now, Superbon fires off another one. So this is the second rear roundhouse kick that he throws in a row. Back, hits the body to where Giorgio hits that three-point block, and a very common counter, he just comes back with a 1-2. When that left straight comes in, Superbon feigns his head off as he fires off his lead hook. Now, this is hooking range. This is tight hooking range. And to throw a head kick from here requires a lot of flexibility and a lot of mobility in the hips and in the side body. So Petrosyan is thinking, I'm just going to fade out. I'm going to exit, and I'm just going to shift my weight back. Well, he doesn't get out enough, because what happens next is the head kick heard around the world. Back. But there's a couple details here. A couple very important details that I want to cover here. Not is it just a focus on range, but there's also a big focus on technique here. We talked about that long guard. Now I'm going to play this clip again for you. I want you to notice the swinging hand of Superbon catches Petrosyan on the head, and it freezes him for a split moment, and that split moment is everything in a fight, because fighting is a game of milliseconds and millimeters, and what happened was cost him the fight. So again, it's three roundhouse kicks in a row from Superbon. Fires off the first one, bang, hits the body. Fires off the second one, here comes that very common counter with that left straight. So as he pulls his leg back, he uses that hip swing for the hook, turns it right into this other kick, but notice the hand. He swings the arm, he clips Petrosyan on the head, freezes him for just a split moment, and here's that head kick right behind it, bang, landing, and it all is concentrated right into his opponent's head, knocking him out. So now I want to show you a combo that you can practice on your own, on the heavy bag, on Bob, and it's the exact same combo that Superbon used to knock out Petrosyan. So we're going to go with the body kick, hook, back to the head kick. Once again, body, hook, head kick. Now again, there's another detail here that Superbon did when throwing his head kick, and it's all on the support foot. So usually when you throw your kicks, you're going to pivot to face the opposite direction with the toes, right? So I swing, bang. But what he does is he actually hops his foot off the ground. And if you notice, when the kick lands, his foot is entirely off the ground. So technically, you could call this a flying or a jumping roundhouse kick. Looks like this. Not super high, just enough to assist with the rotation. So now I want to give you a mobility drill that we can do to work the hips and to also work the obliques to keep the upper body tall. Another important detail. So Bob, if you would, could you take a knee for me, buddy? Appreciate you. So what you can do is you can take a box or a low fence, and you're just going to lift your leg and place it there. Now, this is still a little high. This is like shoulder level for me. So if you have to go a little lower, that's fine. You're going to work your way up. So I'm going to have my toes facing upward. I'm going to have both hips and my support foot facing forward. What I'm going to do now is take the same side hand as the leg that's raised and place it on the opposite shoulder. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pivot on the support foot, and I'm going to turn the knee so I'm throwing a roundhouse kick. As I do that, I swing the arm. Okay, so it's up and out, up and then over. Okay, making sure I'm getting hip and shoulder rotation, but I also want to make sure that this hand is on the head or past the knee. A lot of people, in order to get the height of the roundhouse kick, they'll lean the upper body back. But again, we've looked at that key point of why Petrosyan got knocked out, and it's because his head got clipped with the swinging arm from Superbon. So we have to make sure that we're using our obliques to keep our upper body tall. Our head has to be over the support foot so that we can reach our opponent's head when doing this, okay? So once again, from here and out, here and out. Make sure you are getting your hand past your knee. You're gonna do about 20 reps, then you're gonna switch and go to the opposite side. A great mobility drill, not just for the hips, but also for the obliques and side body. There you have it. That's how Superbon was able to knock out Giorgio Petrosyan, which was hard to watch because he's one of my favorite fighters of all time. But that's the name of the game, and that's what makes it so exciting. Taking the best strikers in the world, matching them up against each other to see who comes out victorious. Speaking of the best fighters in the world, make sure that you tune in on March 26th to 1X, where Superbon is going to be matched up against Marat Grigorian, two of the best strikers in the world, so it's guaranteed fireworks. And make sure you look for me in the crowd because I'm going to be there live in Singapore to watch this monumental event. I seriously cannot wait for this. So make sure you tune into that on March 26th, 1X. Until next time, I'm Shane, and this is Bob. Fight Tips for the Underdogs.